All right, well, you once again, self-love beats the house. And y'all make sure y'all check in next week. It appears we're going to have Bam on the show. We're doing on 1229 Wednesday live right here on TATN. Prison is slavery.
Because of the structures that we have been so accustomed to in this city, and whether you were talking about Al Capone's gang back in the 20s or 30s, or the GDs from the 80s, that there is a notion about Chicago and gangs that when we see violence, there's a tendency to believe that that's what it is.
We have a gentleman who I met in Vegas after my mom passed, and God sent us an angel. And he helped us, you know, carry some of that stuff out of the crib.
I think we certainly need to make sure that we don't have these organizations that are hell-bent on creating violence and mayhem under control. But we also have to make sure that we're addressing why people join gangs, what happens to our social structure when we have kids as young as 9, 10, 11 feeling that there's more comfort and solidarity in a gang structure than they have in their community.
But prison is slavery is next week. We'll say ye so.
Chico Tillman served 16 years in prison for conspiracy to distribute drugs. He too finds the Lightfoot administration's anti-gang focus head-scratching.
The problem is more nuanced than just getting rid of gangs. The entire philosophical view that gangs are pushing the violence is incorrect. I believe it's interpersonal conflicts between individuals who aren't equipped with the skills to be able to resolve it in a peaceful way. I think this happens from living in a state of perpetual trauma where shootings take days.
Prison slavery.
Facts. I'm looking forward to the conversation. I mean, you know, the amendment
13.
Slavery is abolished except for if you were in prison for
anything. For vagrancy, for not having a job.
I was going to say, they went on to make the black codes, which, you know, meant that being black and not having a job meant slavery.
When released from prison, Tillman went back to school at age 40, earning a PhD. He believes he lost his way as a young man because he did not have a mentor.
A role model is a far. Anybody can be a role model. But mentorship is somebody who can walk you through a process.
And you didn't have that.
The challenge is I never had a male figure in my life for a long period of time or had a connection with somebody that had a pathway of success outside of individuals who were athletes, entertainers, or involved in subculture activity.
Give it just a little time. Give it just a little time. You like to sing along.
Yeah. Yeah. You still got chain gangs, but you know, people work in prisons to this day. They might get 3 cents a day or some 25 cents a day or something. It's just ridiculous. But that's what it is. So prison is slavery next week. It's one of our more serious topics.
Raymond Richard, who goes by Brother Raymond, spent 25 years in prison for selling dope, aggravated battery, and other offenses.
They never told me I'd go to jail. They never told me I'd be shot. They never told me I'd be addicted to drugs. They never told me I can wind up homeless.
Today, Brother Raymond and Chico work to keep young boys on the right path.
I joined the gang at 11. I didn't have a mentor. Had I had a mentor, I probably wouldn't have went to the penitentiary 6 times. I probably wouldn't have been left for dead 3 times.
And we're going to have some ex, I don't even like saying ex-offenders, ex, I don't even know, prisoners of war. That sounds right. So we're going to have some former POWs in here. And we're going to chop it up and unpack
that. What a lot of people want. That's real simple. Access, because they can touch, feel, call somebody that actually went a different route and made it.
Y'all check us out on the Self Love Show Wednesday. We have an ex-prisoner of war an ex quote unquote offender. We have two. One did a 22 year stretch in the state of Indiana, and the other gentleman was enslaved in the state of Oklahoma, much shorter time. So we're about lessons, not lectures. Cats who walk the walk. They're gonna get into a little bit of their experience. And they're going to get a little bit into the experience and also words, you know, for our quote-unquote wayward youth, you know, maybe misguided. It's going to be a powerful show. That's what we got, and that brings us to my personal favorite part of the whole shebang, and that's going to be this brother Wordsmith's final words.
Do you still have them?